Okay. Hi, everyone.
Hello.
Hi.
Love your shoes.
Thank you. It's like this gangster. All right. I'm shy, but I will ease myself by making a confession. Confession. If you hear me write anything about Nigeria, write anything about anything that has to do with Nigeria, I was forced to write it. Not because I'm not passionate about Nigeria or the things going on, but I'm a naturally passionate person. When I take something up, I go all out for it. So, you know, taking an issue like Nigeria up and going all out, sometimes you end up with hypertension. So, I just cool down. So, if you hear me say anything about Nigeria, I was forced to write it. The two pieces I'll be doing today, I was forced to write them. But it doesn't mean I won't give it my best. I was forced to write them because I had to present them for something. But it doesn't mean I won't give it my best. First one, hands up for her. That's for the girl child in Nigeria who is being relegated, who nobody's talking about, who is being left at the background because she's a lady or she's a small girl, who is being taken advantage of. Hands up for the lady who we celebrated yesterday and today gave us a baby. Hands up for the baby who in turn grew up to be a fine lady. But today I'd like to know what the price of tomatoes in Osho will be. As she ended up being a sex worker in the faraway country of Italy. I see so many beautiful ladies with potential, but wasting away as they think everything has to be financial. And I look around and I see that she will find she's so crucial. Your child, it doesn't have to be this way, your life can be so phenomenal. I was going to write a prayer for you, so I was looking for the right words. So I went to Google and typed, Nigerian women who have shaped the world. All I saw was a list of Black American women who have shaped their world. Not a single Nigerian man was mentioned by Google and elsewhere. So I began to ask myself, is this a conspiracy? Huh? Is this supposed to lead me to a greater theory? Because the last time I shared Funyala Yannicola Okuti was a Nigerian. Amike Adabiri was a Nigerian. Shomamanda Ngozi Adichie was a Nigerian. Ngozi Okunjuwela was a Nigerian. I, Atilola, am a Nigerian. You, your child, are a Nigerian. So why does the world hands up for her? Why does Google recognize her? Why don't you write a poem or a song for her? Say a prayer for her. Cuddle her. Respect her. Get frustrated and repent of her. Because she's coming around to protect her. To look up for her. Because she's been married at an early age of 13. Politicians keeping quiet as they exchange money bags of quality. Knowing they will never take it even when the plight of their female teens. Oh, this doesn't sound to go on Nigeria's social hygiene. She's being forced to hawk on the streets because her parents cannot afford an education. Wondering if her dreams will ever come to fruition, or she just give up and join the wings of prostitution, as there seems to be no hope for a future celebration. So the girl should listen to me when I say you are worth more than gold. Your life doesn't have to be that of a story which remains unsold. By Google, the outer world, or a dysfunctional system which has decided to put your life on hold. You can decide to do something worthwhile and stand on hold. So hands up for the girl child who has decided to make her nation proud. And if she has something to offer, she must be allowed. And if you haven't helped her reach that place where she wears that crown, then keep those hands up and never let them down. Yeah. This headaches. Loud noise, thumping sounds, ferocious stars, reminding me of electronic binaries. Oh, no, not the one caused by the pumping of the blood from my heart through my arteries. My description of the sound in my ear is not melodious like the voice of canaries. This headaches. It's caused by the alarming drain of our natural and human resources. Yesterday, the corpse of my long lost neighbor was brought from the northern geology. Let sorrow caused by one so ignorant that he despises Western ideology. Yet he uses Western technology to perpetuate his evil theology. Aggravated by leaders who have nothing to offer but a hypocritical apology. Makes me think the living in Nigeria is nothing but a mythology. But still, I can't give up on my blindly optimistic politic ideology, so I get down on my knees and offer Almighty my ever sweet doxology. It's headaches. It's caused by the numerous blind news flying around us like careless grenades in the war zone. Justice has been taken from the ones who deserve it and left in the hands of those who kidnapped it. In form of a 750,000 naira pipe or billions of naira theft, they purchased it. Another news that we buried in the graveyards of the political pundits. It's caused by the hopeless Nigerians trying to sell the hopeful Nigerians like the Dementors in the Harry Potter series. After applying for the US visa lottery over and over again, my uncle finally won it the third time. With years of hard work and heavy tax, he sent me a loan with an expensive Seiko watch, which had cost him every dime. I made that Seiko watch a symbol of hope for me, because it connected the land of more opportunities to one of the great opportunities. Oh, nothing must tamper with this. So I pampered it. Loved it, polished it, and I could see the reflection of my face in it. On the fateful night of a very difficult day after waiting and for hours at the bus stop without justification, I was happy to be lucky enough to get the last chance to my final destination. But all I ended up with was a wrist sheet of my symbol of hope. My Seiko watch gone. Hope gone. My heart wailed, my mind cried, but my mouth couldn't utter a sound. Because the one last chance I entered had almost stripped me of a hope so profound. And that night, I stopped hoping in this country because I realized there was no action I could take because my hands were bound. But the next morning, surprisingly, just like Jesus couldn't be held down by grave, my hope found a new way to resurrect. I had not given it permission, but it still pushed me to believe in a Nigerian future so perfect. I guess my hope was wiser than me, knowing a hopeless man is analogous to a walking dead, and a walking dead better commit suicide rather than be a waste of earthly space and carry a brainless head. Yes, this headaches. It's caused by the numerous times my hopes told me never to give up. So in spite of all, I see hope and keep my head up. Because I shoot my hope away a long time ago, but like a forceful and insecure boyfriend, he knows how to find me no matter where I go. Begging me to believe in my country. And maybe one day, when I'm 70, or even bedridden and 90, these dividends I'll finally receive.
Oh, my God.